Hello everybody, welcome to another video. As always, if you're new, consider hitting subscribe and liking this video. Today is part 3 of types of players in Cat Simulator Canimal Life. If you haven't watched the previous two parts, I go watch them right now. Links will be in the description. Before we begin, please remember, this video is only for entertainment purposes and is not intended to insult anybody who plays the game. Now that that's out of the way, let's begin the video. Number 1. The person who swears they know everybody. Usually if you have some sort of font in your name, they'll be suspicious of you. For some reason they swear they know all 1 million plus players on the game. They'll sometimes try really hard to get something out of you. Number 2. The toxic people. Doesn't matter how nice you are to them, they'll usually lash out at you for no reason. They'll be rude to everyone in the server, out of spite sometimes. They never have a moment of positivity, and only want drama even if people hate them. Afterwards, nobody knows where these people come from and why they act like this. Word of advice, if you see one, mute them. Number 3. The AF dude. Usually these people are just eavesdropping on the chat. They're always online, but somehow high in level. They have an extra sense indicating when someone's about to attack them. They'll sit in the same spot for hours at a time. Number 4. The WAD YouTuber clones. These people are everywhere, especially the WAD clones. Usually they're not impersonating, just big fans of said YouTubers. Sometimes their names can get ridiculous, but usually they're chill and provide no harm. Number 5. The role players. These people spend hours role playing. These people put in the most effort as they can into their role plays. You can tell these people are passing English because of the amount of detail implemented into them. Nothing can stop them from role playing. Number 6. The people who try to scare others. They exist only for the purpose of scaring and trolling little kids. They usually pretend to be hackers or something close to that. They'll threaten you by saying they're going to do something they can, such as taking your money or finding where you live, which is not true at all. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this video, maybe you'll enjoy my other ones too. Consider liking and subscribing if you enjoyed this video. I'm not too sure about a possible part 4, but if we get a ton of likes on this one, I might consider it. But anyways, goodbye and see you soon. Have a good day.